I'm Dr. Kara Stewart from Purdue University. The purpose of this video today is to properly demonstrate how to collect a hair sample for your 4-H swine project. A DNA hair sample will be required for every gilt or barrow that you want to enroll in the state fair. First, let's discuss some of the items you'll need to get prepared in advance of taking your hair sample. First, you're going to need to go to your county extension office to get an envelope to collect the hair samples in. You'll need to fill out all the information on the front of the envelope for each individual pig that you wish to enroll in the fair. Second, you're going to need a pair of pliers. Any pair of pliers from the farm or from your house that you have available will do fine to remove the hair from the pig. Finally, you're going to need a Clorox wipe or any kind of sanitizing wipe. This will only be necessary if you wish to enroll more than one pig, and that will be used to clean the pliers in between each hair sample collection from each pig to make sure there aren't residual hairs being transferred from one envelope to the next. So let's head out and show you how to collect the hair.
First, you'll need to clean the hair collection area with a dry towel to remove any dirt or other contaminants. Recommended sites are on the loin or rump, but if the animal's been shaved, other areas could be used to pull hair samples as well. In our experience, the longer the hair, the easier it is to get a good grip and remove the follicle. Use your pliers to pull the hair. Pull the hair directly away from the animal, not at an angle, in order to be sure that the roots come out. Repeat this process about 4 to 5 times till you get a minimum of 40 hair samples with follicles on them in order to get a good DNA sample. After each pull, visually inspect the hairs to ensure the roots or follicles are attached, as seen here in the red circle. If the roots are not present, discard the sample and start over with another pull. Place each sample directly into the self-sealing collection envelope. You'll want to avoid touching the roots or using any plastic bags, so just turn the pliers upside down and gently shake them into the envelope to let the hairs fall down into the envelope. Again, you'll want to do about 5 pulls in order to get a minimum of 40 hairs with follicles in the envelope. When you're done, turn the envelope over and remove the strip to seal the collection envelope. If you are going to register more than one animal, you can go repeat this process for all the remaining animals. The collection envelopes then will need to be turned into your county extension office. In summary, remember, you can get the envelopes from your county extension office, and the deadline for enrollment is May 15th. Be sure you pull the hair samples, do not cut them, and inspect them for the presence of the follicles. Do not touch the hair samples as you load them into the envelopes. You'll need a minimum of 40 hairs with follicles present, which will likely require about 4 to 5 pulls. For hogs that are co-enrolled among siblings, only one DNA sample envelope is required. Just be sure to list all siblings' names on the same collection envelope. This is required for all of your barrows and gilts that you want to be eligible for the Indiana State Fair. For questions about this process, please contact your local county 4-H educator or Aaron Fisher. For specific requirements related to your county-only hogs, please contact your county extension office.
This presentation was a production of the Animal Science Department at Purdue University.